James Mayberry and his wife Louisa are on their honeymoon, fishing aboard a charter boat near Key West. Their fishing trip takes a shocking turn when James unexpectedly pulls up a severed human arm instead of a fish. There is some panic and excitement. The boat's mate gets the limb off the line and in a cool box. Yancey, the main character of the series, is a detective suspended from the Miami Police Department. He's enjoying quiet time in front of his house at the seaside and not answering any messages or calls to his phone. Yancey is approached by a fellow detective, Rogelio Burton, to bring the severed arm to the medical examiner's office in Miami. Rogelio said that according to the coroner, the arm came from a mid-40 white male. The middle finger is sticking out of the dead hand. According to the coroner, this is probably just random rigor mortis. Yancey reluctantly accepts this task. Dr. Rosa Campesino, the medical examiner in Miami, examines the severed arm. She observes a wedding ring, still on its finger, and that there used to be a watch on the arm. She can't match it to a victim in their database, so refuses to take the arm into custody. Vance tried her to keep the arm because Sonny Summers, the local sheriff, doesn't want publicity around it. The arm might hurt tourism. On the way back to the Keys, Rogelio advises Yancey to just ditch the arm to crocodiles. He almost did this, but then placed it in his freezer, which is where Yancey's girlfriend, Bonnie, finds it and freaks out. Bonnie is married to Cliff, who caught them. He is the one pressing the charges that led to Yancey's suspension, because Yancey rammed Cliff and his golf cart into the sea. Yancey asks Bonnie to ask the dermatologist to drop the case. He also wonders why Bonnie doesn't divorce Cliff and why she uses a fake name. Neville is a young man living very leisurely in the Bahamas. His home is the fishing cottage that his dad built. He has a diapered pet monkey that he won in a card game. Neville's half-sister in Florida had the land title, and she sold Neville a Tom, and she met an American developer called Christopher. She must split the money of the sale with Neville. Christopher is building a large resort called Curly Tail Lane. He also bought the local bar run by Neville's friend. They want to fight back. The bartender convinces Neville to pay the scary and seductive Dragon Queen, a local Obeah sorcery witch, to put a curse on Christopher. Yancey hates the big yellow house that was constructed next to his beach house. He loves teasing the agent and preventing him to sell it, for example, with a dead raccoon and a colony of bees. Yancey learns from Rodrigo that the arm belonged to Nick Stripling. Yancey returns the arm to his ex-wife, Eve, so that they can have a funeral. Yancey even goes to join the funeral, where he meets Nick Stripling's daughter, who hates her stepmother, Eve. The daughter tells Yancey that she's sure Eve killed her dad and also replaced her dad's wedding ring with a cheaper version. There are two federal agents overlooking the funeral, indicating this case might be bigger than just insurance fraud. Sheriff Sonny wasn't happy Yancey continued stirring up the severed arm case and fires him. Yancey meets the young lad, Pinny, that pulled up the severed arm that day on the boat. He's with his girlfriend, Madeline. Yancey asks him how a dumb guy like him can spend a lot of money. The lad walks out into the rain and gets shot dead by a guy on a scooter.